Why does King Neptune look different in the movie than he does on the show? That's weird.
SpongeBob, Patrick, it's time to start your journey. Drive the paddy wagon from Bikini Bottom to the edge of town. This road will take you through Bikini Bottom to the edge of town. Don't let the paddy wagon take too much damage, or you'll have to start again.
Our journey begins. Epic, heroic, daring, valiant, courageous!
SpongeBob, you're driving a sandwich.
Not just a sandwich, a Krabby Patty.
Cheese!
The cheese looks orange. So why is it that SpongeBob can drive the paddy wagon, but he can't drive a car? And there's our first extra. There's not really a rush in this level because there's no time limit, but you'll have to, but that's different with the time challenges and the ring challenges. And there is another treasure back here. Oh, I have to push square to turn around. I was hoping I'd be able to smash through the boxes. Why are there plankton crates everywhere? There was an episode called The Greasy Buffoons where Mr. Krabs was using grease in the Krabby Patties, and in that episode he had SpongeBob driving a truck. So I don't get how he can drive a truck and the paddy wagon but not a car. Sometimes it sounds like SpongeBob writers just don't care about their quality. Or felt like that after the first movie came out. But I've heard that it got better when Steven Hillenburg came back after the second season. I mean, after the second movie. But I haven't been keeping up with Modern SpongeBob. And I can't because I don't have Nickelodeon. But I've heard it's getting better. Unfortunately, Steven Hillenburg has passed away. So I'm not sure how the quality of the show is now. The birthday celebration episode last year was pretty good, and hopefully this new movie is.
You've reached the edge of town, and now you can go on to the next part of your journey. Here's your reward. Come back again if you want another driving challenge.
With the chaos of Bikini Bottom behind us, SpongeBob and Patrick begin their long journey towards Shell City. However, with SpongeBob gone, all is not well. For Plankton is now selling the Krabby Patty at the Chum Bucket. And with every purchase, customers are getting a mind-controlling bucket helmet. Squidward has discovered Plankton's plan to create an army of bucket heads. Will Squidward save the day?
No.
On the outskirts of town, SpongeBob and Patrick meet some of the charming locals who tell them they will not last long outside the city. But our friends are listening. They should have listened.
They lasted 12 seconds.
Our heroes are now stranded in a vast desert with only their feet for transportation.
Now I can teach you the bash move.
Now I am the master.
Wow! Thanks, Mindy!
Those radio towers are broadcasting Plankton's hypnotizing messages. If we don't do something soon, every creature in the sea will be under Plankton's control. You have to go into the desert and shut them down.
Isn't this the really dangerous desert that no one has ever returned from?
No. I think that's the desert next to this one.
Oh! Well, in that case, I'll have those towers shut down in a jiffy.
Yeah, except we're gonna do that later. We got more driving to do.
Try a time challenge?
I'm challenged all the time.
Good one, buddy.
Yeah. Wait, what?
You'll have a set time limit to get to the end of the road. If you finish in less than the set time, I'll reward you.
I've heard some people say that, that the ring challenges and time challenges for the vehicle levels are like padding. And yeah, I can kind of see that, because if you want to 100% the game, you have to go back and do them. And I don't think Battle for Bikini Bottom really had any padding, at least none that I can really remember. This game does have more challenges than Battle for Bikini Bottom, like the driving levels, and there are some SpongeBob challenges in the game, whereas the SpongeBob in the first game was mostly used to, like, get you to places quicker, whereas there's, like, levels dedicated to them in this, whereas in Battle for Bikini Bottom, the only level really dedicated to the SpongeBob in battle was the SpongeBob Arena at the end of the game. Seriously, why does that cheese look so orange? That's kind of weird. I kind of wish there was like a real life paddy wagon. I'd buy one. These level, the ring challenges put up more of a challenge than the timed ones do, because if you miss one, you have to start over. Well, you can't really miss one, because one doesn't come up until the other one is already been gone through. But, if you take too long or mess up, then you have to start all over, and it gets annoying. See what I mean? Exactly, that. Wish I had something to talk about, but I kinda don't. This level does that to me. Probably because this is the third time we've seen this level. No. Don't really want to start this again, especially not now. A new upgrade. We'll check that out soon.
Easy? Yeah, it was easy.
Oh, very easy.
All right.
give you a hard time to beat. Get to the end of the road in less than the set time.
Well, let's see what they got. Let's upgrade the bash. See in here. Please, oh, thank God. If I was just 1 second late.
You did it! You can try and beat your best time on this road.
We'll do it, Mindy. Nothing can distract us.
Wheels on the paddy wagon go round and round.
You don't get a token for that, so we're just gonna go 3,000 miles to Shell City.